Recording started.
Good morning and welcome to Mercy Morning Tea.
Good morning, everybody. We have had quite a morning, haven't we, Steve?
Yes, we have. Julie, we've barely seen each other in the last 4 weeks.
It's true.
We had to cancel a show 2 weeks ago.
We're sorry.
Today we were supposed to be back and live. Brad's back, you're back, I'm here.
It was a nightmare in the parking garage
and
today.
Then we had a hurricane blow through Springfield this morning.
Yes.
Which led to me parking in the garage, and I didn't remember where I parked.
No, so we were walking through the second floor, the third floor, the fourth floor, the fifth floor.
It was on the third floor.
Back to the third floor till we found your car.
So anyway, we found the car.
Yeah.
And here we are. We made it. We're not live, but we are recording today's
show.
And we have a great show today.
We do. We actually have a really great show. And today we're going to be talking about one of the ways that we can live out the works of mercy, how we respond to this healing ministry of Jesus that we are called to live out every day. How do we feed the hungry? How do we provide shelter for those that need it? How do we help people just meet their basic needs every day?
And, you know, right now there's a lot of conversation and a lot out there about charities. In particular, we've seen a lot with the Ice Bucket Challenge.
We've seen
the Pink Slime Challenge.
Yeah.
There's all sorts of challenges happening out there. And all of those are for really good charities. And so we thought we would focus on charity today. And what is charity and why give to charity?
Right.
And, you know, charity really is, from a common good perspective, charity is when we recognize that there are individuals or groups of people, communities, that have needs that they could not take care of on their own. You know, a lot of times we hear people say, well, why don't they just get a job? Why don't they just fill in the blank, right? What is it that they need to do? But there are moments in people's lives and communities' lives where they cannot do for themselves. And we've seen that in many of the communities, and we see that today in many of the communities in which Mercy serves. And so that's why we are asked as Mercy co-workers to give back.
Yes, we give to the Mercy Way campaign, and when we do that, it affects so many people. So there is a video on Bagot Street that you can find that will show you the ways that our money helps so many people. And some of the ways, I know the reason why a lot of times that I give is to see the effects that my money provides. So being able to provide a home for people in times of need, like when the tornado, when it struck Oklahoma City and Joplin, some of our Mercy Way campaign money went to help people through that time. Also, I know that there is scholarships available for people that want to go back to school in some of our communities.
Right.
Some of our coworkers want to further their education.
Yeah,
so
we have coworkers who want to go back to school but can't necessarily do that on their own.
Right.
They need others to step up and help them.
Right, and so we get to be able to do that.
Right, yeah.
Every community has the crisis fund for their coworkers.
Mm-hmm.
So when there's an opportunity to give to that, I find that that's probably the best way to do that and to help people that have a need, such as when a parent dies and there's no money for a funeral, then through that crisis fund we might be able to help that. But to just be able to provide their basic needs is so important for us.
Yeah, and when I think about giving to charity and the way that I approach giving to charity, I'm just going to share this with our viewers today and share it with you. But there are three questions that I always ask myself. The first one being, is there a need? Is there a real need? An opportunity where the people who benefit from my gift, could they do it without my help? Could they, you know, when we think about the Ice Bucket Challenge, you have individuals who are, you know, who really are struggling with this serious disease.
Right.
They can't find a cure all by themselves. It does take a community to gather around them, to support, to fund research and to offer support. And so, well, one of the questions I always ask myself is, what is the need? And is the need real?
Mm-hmm.
Could they do it all by themselves? And if the answer is no, then there is a real need.
Right.
And then the second question is, or what are my desires? What am I passionate about?
Mm-hmm.
What are the things that kind of grab my heart? So there are certain charities that I'm more loyal to,
charities I'm
more committed to, because it tugs at my desires, tugs at my heart, and that's okay. It's important that we follow our desires. ours, because when we do, we're more prone to give.
Exactly.
And the third question that I always ask is, then what is my capacity to give?
Yeah.
What can I give without burdening some of my other responsibilities?
Right.
I mean, we want people to give, but not give so that it hurts themselves or their families or others, right?
Right. So. Right, and there's that sense of people talk about sacrificial giving. We don't
right.
want people to have to sacrifice their basic needs in order to provide
right.
Maybe for somebody else's, but no. to be able to give in such a way that makes sense for them.
No, sacrificial giving could be sacrificing one fancy coffee a week.
That's
or
really true.
Sacrificing,
right. Right.
You know, that, you know, maybe you go to just one movie a week instead of two
right.
movies a week or whatever. Whatever. Those are the kinds
yeah.
of sacrifices maybe
That's
we
what
can
I
make.
Think of too. Yeah, maybe you take your lunch rather than buying it at the cafeteria
right.
that day. So there are ways to do that. And even if it's just $5, that
mm-hmm.
makes a huge difference for someone
right.
in need.
So we encourage you to think about what are the needs in your community.
Yeah.
Look at watch the video and look at the Mercy Way campaign materials that
right.
show what the needs are in the communities we serve.
Yeah, and there might be a certain fund that you want to give to specifically through the Mercy
right.
Way campaign. So designate your money when that happens.
To
I know.
Crisis fund,
mm-hmm.
to an education fund.
Yep.
There's all sorts of things. For the pediatric.
The infant bereavement program.
Right.
That we
all
have.
Sorts of programs mm-hmm. have funds set up for them. We thought we would share today one of the reasons that we give. And so I don't know if you can all see this very well, but the reason that I give, Julie, is because sometimes I can't thrive all by myself. There are times even when I need and my needs have been met by others.
Right.
And I'm grateful for that, and that's what motivates me
yeah.
to give.
Right. And I give because I want to help. That's pretty basic. But
pretty
I really
simple.
Do want to help, and when I see a need, I want to step in there and be able to provide and support that person and encourage them along the way. So that's why I like to give.
Julie is a helper. She held my hand as I cried in the parking lot this morning.
It is true.
So, Julie, we have this big cup here.
Yes.
It's a big teacup.
A big, giant teacup.
So today we are going to invite each other and invite our viewers. I'm going to challenge my Aunt Rosie, who's a faithful viewer. I'm going to challenge Brad, who's working the camera today, and
yeah.
Sister Richard Mary, our friend in our office, to take this challenge to give back to the Mercy
yeah.
Way.
That's right. And I'm going to challenge our healthification gals that work downstairs from where we're at right now, Alyssa and Becca, to do this teacup challenge to give to the Mercy Way
teacup
campaign.
Teacup challenge.
Yeah, that's what I'm calling it. It's a big, giant teacup.
Ooh.
And I, yeah. So,
do you have anyone else?
I think that's a good
Who's
start.
Who's doing this? Who's being challenged this morning?
Who's being challenged?
I'll be the sacrificial recipient.
You've had such a bad day. This will
this
really
is gonna
make
cheer
it
us
fun.
Up. So anyway, if you take the teacup challenge, go ahead and record it and put it on our Facebook page, or you can send it to our email.
All right. Here we go.
All right. Here we go. Give to the Mercy Way.
Yeah. And as Catherine McCauley said, resolve to be good today.
But better tomorrow.
That totally went down my shirt.